This is how they stand in La Liga ahead of the first Clasico of the year. Barcelona and Real Madrid locked together on 35 points. They play on Wednesday at the Nou Camp, a game originally scheduled for October the 26th, called off due to security concerns. This is how the odds makers see it, and it's Barcelona who are prohibitive favourites at 7-5 on Real Madrid. Well, you can get more than 3-1, also 3-1 on the draw. How do we see it, Ali?
Well, what we see from both of these teams is they're both vulnerable. Mm. They both have issues. Defensively, there's concern on both parts. Defensively, also out of the midfield, not only the back line, but also out of the midfield, there is a lack of athleticism for Barcelona when Sergio Busquets is playing that is very clear. And so when Barcelona is unable to control the pace of the game with their possession, which they haven't been able to do this year as consistently as they have over the last few seasons, and we have come to expect that from Barcelona, then they go in a back and forth. When they go in a back and forth, they get exposed in the midfield because they simply cannot defend. They don't have in Busquets, a guy that can keep up and close the space to other players that are far more athletic than him. So that forces Frankie de Jong into a further back position, which takes him away from being in the attacking half and then forces Lionel Messi into a playmaking area. And so for me, Barcelona must control the pace of the game, must control the possession, and cannot get in a back and forth with Real Madrid. If they do, they're asking for trouble. Force Real Madrid to defend, because when Real Madrid has to defend, they have proven that they have their own difficulties. Mm.
In some sense, throwing Rakitic in there as well, and I don't know if he'll play, but he did at the weekend. Throwing Rakitic in there as well, he's very much in the same ball game as Busquets, where he's been a quality player, he's a great thinker about the game, and he's very clever, but he can't get around the field.
Yeah.
It's just Mother Nature. They just cannot get around the field like they once did. And that puts... And in some sense, you think, well, OK, bringing a young guy in sort of helps that out, but it's put so much pressure on the midfield and they've become so easy to play through at times. And it's been a difficult headache for them. And, of course, when Messi wasn't in the team, nobody was able to sort of bail them out. And ultimately, it's going to come down to, I think, being at home, Valverde getting the balance right of his team and Lionel Messi having another game of his life. If that happens, I think Barcelona win the game.
It's interesting, isn't it? Because neither team are at their scintillating best.
So because of that, I think definitely the home advantage comes into it. But because of that as well, I think Barcelona are more settled in their 11. Mm. You know, Zidane's made a lot of changes, whether it's in the middle of the park or up front. There's no Hazard. Does he play Bale? Does he not? Does he play Rodrigo? At least with Barcelona, you know what the middle three... It's Busquets, Rakitic. Rakitic, no question for me, and De Jong. And then the front three picks itself as well. So I just think that they're more settled. And I think that makes a difference when it comes to a big game like this.
I think the presence of Jordi Alba as well, who just came back from injury, played about 60 minutes or so against Real Sociedad over the weekend. That's a natural outlet down the left-hand side, something that they did not have when he was out of when he was out with injury. Him coming back gives him a different option, something that we have seen so many times Lionel Messi cutting inside from the right-hand side and then looking for that switch over to Jordi Alba. If he's able to then force Carvajal back and he's able to force Real Madrid into defensive positions, then that creates more spaces underneath where Antoine Griezmann can tuck inside, even though he shouldn't be doing that. Lionel Messi is going to create from there, and then Luis Suarez and Messi combined, it has been the difference for Barcelona over the last couple of weeks.
Gab, I believe it's the 243rd competitive meeting between these two. Which way is it going to go?
Well, what I find fascinating here is, as the boys were alluding to, it's really difficult to guess what Zidane is going to do. He's used so many different looks. I love what he did at the weekend against Valencia, where you had Isco and Modric, and then effectively Benzema and Rodrigo as strikers. Obviously, Casemiro will be back. He didn't play at the weekend because he was a yellow card away from suspension. I could see Real Madrid going Casemiro, Valverde with Toni Kroos and hunkering down a little bit. But most of all, what's interesting here is if you're Zidane, you can get an edge. You can out-coach and out-tactic Valverde. Valverde, we know what his lineup's going to be, and it's going to come down to the individual qualities, and then, you know, if Messi or Griezmann do something, then you're out of it. But this is a situation where I think, you know, Zidane can earn his bacon, and I think he will. I'm going to go for the draw here.
John, you see it the same way?
I think this is a type of fixture where it would be very interesting in about 3 or 4 years' time when you see what lineup Valverde went with in the San Siro, when a group of youngsters went there and there were some unbelievable performances from Carlos Perez and one or two more, that they really went there and put a statement performance in. And likewise with Real Madrid, when you think of Rodrigo, Vinicius Jr., Valverde, who I'm a massive fan, and I've been on this show probably the last couple of weeks raving about him, Uruguayan midfield player that looks like Toni Kroos and plays like him, but he's got more athleticism, can go box to box very easy. So this fixture is going to be fascinating in a few years' time when all these young boys get a little bit of maturity. Again, this one's a hard one to call. I think, as Gab said, if Griezmann and Suarez is fit and Messi, they turn it on, they'll be hard to beat. But at the same time, I fancy Real Madrid's midfield. I think Gab's right. I think the three in midfield, I think, almost picks itself. I think Casemiro's 100% a starter. And Toni Kroos and Valverde's the players alongside him. So it's going to be fascinating. I think at the top end of the picture, I think Barca just edge it.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.